Electronic Pots. Power bank. So it takes 18650 and acts as a power bank. Yeah. Okay. This is 24 volt output AC to DC adapter. I hope this works from 48 volt. I have to test this. It seems that this is chopped off from AC adapter case or something. Here is wires sticking out. 5 volts output. Okay. These are these USB lights. I had this problem when I'm under the desk connecting something. I cannot see. Blue light is on. See what voltage is. Yes, it works. So, is it always on? Okay. Now it's off. But still, output voltage. And now when I put load, then it lights up 2 milliamps, and now waiting into off state, so 700 microamps when off. Five months, so it's not bad. Maybe if this is lower voltage, then the current also gets lower. Can we power hard drive from it? Pretty neat. Yes, it's working. Let's measure the output amperage. Mm-hmm. 0.7 amps. $1 power bank. It's working. So 50 volt input, and let's try 300 ohms. It's about 100 milliamps, 2 watts, 23 volts at 50 volt DC input. I can adjust this resistor to make it 19 volts, so I can use it my kitchen motion detector. But this is not working even at 19 volts, no output. Maybe this is broken, I don't know. Yeah, 5 volts, so 230 volt AC, it works. But not in DC, even at 100 volts, still not working. These items was from SenseCore. This AC-DC converter, $1.59, power bank $1.17, 10 pieces LED lamps, $2.34,
and this 24 volt AC-DC converter, $1.64.
Portable digital voltmeter, 0 to 100 volts. Yes. So I can use this to display my battery voltage, and it needs 3 to 3 volts. I can use this AC-DC mini converters for this.
These 100 volt voltmeters was from 9 Enjoy Shopping. 5 pieces, red. Red is cheapest.
Power meter. So this is 33 volt, 3 amp current meter. I'm starting to love these. These are very compact and shows everything in one go, and it has memory. You can save. It has multiple memory, and one is not memory, not saving, and other is saving, and it's very nice. You can choose if you want to reset always if you power off, or if you don't, you can choose another option. So it's not resetting if you turn it off, and it's pretty accurate too. No. So this power meter, $8.39. It's weird, it doesn't ship to Estonia anymore. Here is shows the battery will not go over 20 volts. So to go 100 volts, you must use external DC to DC converter. But these are cheap, you know. This modules is under $1, and you can use up to 300 volts DC to convert to 5 volts. So this not be problem. I wanted to use for my charger, so I know how much I charge. Okay, this bigger. Bigger box. It's a multimeter. Digital multimeter user's manual. It's very cheap and auto range. I always use these very cheap meters, which has not auto range. It's very annoying, but cheap and auto range. I use this just for basic measurements. I hope this it's reasonably accurate. It's 9 volt battery. To probe even. Let's see. Okay, 3.61, and when I measure that, 0.001 voltage difference, so it's very promising. AC voltage. Let's measure my off-grid inverter mains voltage. Will it blow up or not? Okay, it's reasonable. About 1 volt difference. It's very pretty cool. This shows more accurate. Very fast. But let's measure this. How fast this is. It's weird that the cheapest multimeters are faster than very expensive and professional multimeters. I think this is because of software. Okay, this is hard to use like this, but
this multimeter is not available from this seller anymore, but mine was $13.05. But I found another seller now sells $12.60. Pretty cheap. And out of range and everything. So, pretty good deal.
Wi-Fi smart power socket. This works and setup was very easy. And no lag. Nice. Here I can share timer and countdown. Very nice. So it works through EV-Link server, so now you know don't have to be local network. You can use this everywhere where is internet, and it always works. So this is, let me show you. Screwdriver. This is mini PCI Express to PCI Express adapter. Example, if you need firewall, there's no other way to get firewire from mini PCI Express. Maybe there are some cards available, but these are very expensive. So I hope this works. I put this to my mini ITX board and here. Just put it here and now I have mini PCI Express firewire card. Here is USB 2 and it needs power also, 5 volts and 12 volts, standard floppy plug. So I hope this works.
And this PCI riser extension cord adapter card drop shipping was $11.26.
This is if you have multiple HDMI sources You can connect these three all here and select the input. I think I can use this for my camera and PC, so I can view camera picture on big screen and select. Okay. Nice, it's just cable connects here. So I connected this up. One is GoPro Hero, one is this camera that I'm using for recording, and one is my laptop. So three inputs and one screen. This is my laptop input. Now if I click this button, now this is my GoPro Hero camera, and when I press again, then this is this camera. So it seems it works. PC and GoPro camera. Nice. And this HDMI, auto switch, splitter, switcher, hub box, cable for DVD, HDTV, SDPL, was from Lavec 1020, and it costed only $3.86, pretty cheap. Well, I think this custom may have opened. It looks expensive, but it's not actually. HDMI splitter. This I can theoretically just output laptop to two monitors simultaneously. Yes, input HDMI input power. It needs power. Output 1 and output 2. Nice schematic. Can you see what's here?
Mine costed $8.40 free shipping. And now same seller, AutoNVHK. Now it's $11 and $3 shipping. Whoa, about half more expensive. Weird.
Better working tooling. Dial indicator. Nice package. Nice. Nice. So I can test this how deep things are.
Indicator, accuracy, measurement, instrument, gauge, precision rule, dial indicator, new, was from Snake Wong 2005 and $6.59.
plug. It's mini display port to display port adapter. I have this 4K adapter, display port to HDMI 2.0, 4K 60Hz, and my work laptop has only mini display port, so I can use this to get 4K 60Hz to TV from my laptop.
And this mini display port, the display port female adapter converter, was from full of $365, $1.27.
Mini phone tripod.
This tripod was from Lion's store, $2.49. This mini tripod was from Six Plaza, 2014, $7.60.
Pressure switch, so very smashed pad. So this is for my water pump. My water pump pressure switch failed, so I bought new one from eBay. Okay. Here's good contacts.
And this water pump pressure control switch double spring pole was from Cherry Blossom 2015, $7.13. Plus shipping, $1.68.
shower mixer, cold hot. Here you can choose temperature and flow. Really scraping sound, feels very cheap, but it's 2 times cheaper than here. So I bought it from England.
This shower mixer was from Ucool, and he's not selling this anymore. So I saw this here, $33.76, and it works.
I think I know what these are. These are soldering iron tips. I have this 100 watt soldering iron, and this tip very bad very quickly, so I have to replace this. If this works. Yep, should be okay.
And this solder tip, this seller is not selling this anymore, was $6.03 from Happy Leuki.
Metric and width on measuring gauge. This is my I can measure threads made in Germany. Metric and Whitworth. Nice. Says it's stainless, so let's try. Yeah, right. It's not stainless steel. Fake, not stainless. Too bad. And this measuring gauge was from DSE by $7.44, but stainless steel, no, it's not, it's regular steel, so fake. This is switch for e-bike. I had this switch about 5 years and now it failed from because of rain or something like that, and I bought new. And this 3-speed which switch got from Jewelry Base, $1.78. Pretty cheap.